God bless you, dear students. This is your Islamiyat lesson, section 3, chapter number 1, Life in Makkah. Students, today I will share some subtopics with you: Harbul Fazl, Halful Fazl, Al Sadiq and Al Amin, Marriage to Khadija, Fixing of Black Stones. Students, you know, Harbul Fazl is very important in the life of Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wa sallam. Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wa sallam was about 15 years old when a sacrilegious war of Harbul Fajr broke out between the Quraysh and Hawazin tribes. The war was so called because it was fought during the sacred months when fighting was forbidden. Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wa sallam accompanied his uncle, but he didn't take an active part in the war. He only collected the arrows thrown by the enemies and handed them over to his uncle. Students, this was a major event in the life of Hazrat Muhammad, peace be upon him, and one which must have had a great impact on his character. His impressions of the war was most probably concerned with the tragic results of the war, the bloodshed and the unnecessary human suffering. Being the first armed conflict that he witnessed, he could not have escaped its influence on his mind and peace-loving temperament, and he must have developed a very strong and lasting dislike for war. At the same time, his indirect participation in the war also gave a military experience that is so vital for any person to be leader of people through a major socio-religious revolution. Students, next is Halful Fazl. As a result of Fajr war, thousands of lives were lost. When the leaders of Makkah saw the effects of the war, they found a league called Halful Fazl with the object of maintaining peace in the region, also for suppressing any violence and injustice and upholding the rights of the weak, poor and destitute. This alliance was called Al-Fazl after three of the main participants, each of whom was called Al-Fazl. It is also suggested that this alliance was called Al-Fazl because it was made for a noble cause. The name suggests maintaining honor. Students, the Hashemite under the leadership of Zubair bin Abdul Muttalib, along with some other tribes, assembled in the house of noble Quraysh Abdullah bin Judan and pledged to stand on the side of the oppressed, whether stranger or citizens, against the oppressor and to remove injustice from the land. Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was among those who attended the meeting and was so impressed by its noble objectives, but he remained loyal to it. Later on, he said, "I was in the house of Abdullah bin Judan at the excellent pact that I would not exchange any part in it for a herd of red camels. And if in Islam I were summoned onto it, I would greatly respond." Students, Sadiq al-Amin. In his early life, the Holy Prophet ﷺ worked as a shepherd and took care of the families and neighbors' herds. When he grew up, he started to trade, unlike other businessmen of the time. He was extremely honest and fair in his dealing, and always found him very honest in his dealing. He never picked quarrels. The Holy Prophet was very honest. He nor made any false statement. His honesty and truthfulness impressed the people to such an extent that they gave him a title of Al-Sadiq, the truthful, and Al-Amin, the truthworthy. They would also entrust their valuables to him for safekeeping even after the declaration of prophethood. They had so much faith in his honesty and trustworthiness that they continued to leave their valuables with him for safe custody. Students, the honesty and truthfulness impressed the people to such an extent that they gave him the titles of Al-Sadiq, the truthful, and Al-Amin, the trustworthy. Marriage to Khadija. At that time, they lived in Makkah, a wealthy and respectable widow, Khadija, daughter of a wealth, who was the great-grandson of Qusay. He was very impressed by the honesty and goodness of Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He was 40 years and old and twice widow. Khadija was 40 years old and twice widow, you know. She had two sons and a daughter from her previous marriages. On account of her exceptional character, she was known as Zahira, the pious one. She requested Hazrat Muhammad to take her merchandise to Syria against a share in profits. She also sent to slave Masera, also spoke of his fair dealings of Hazrat Khadija. At that time, he was 25 and she was 40. The union proved successful. They had two sons and four daughters. Both the sons died in infancy. Of the daughters, only the youngest Fatima Raziella survived the Holy Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Students, fixing a black stone is very important in Islamic history. Hajar al-Aswad. Black stone is called Hajar al-Aswad. Kaaba is situated at the lowest part of the valley, in the valley of Haran, and was always flooded by rain water. The people of Makkah tried various methods to stop this flooding, but that all their efforts failed and building was damaged by flood. They therefore decided to rebuild the task of rebuilding. The Kaaba was divided among the leading families of Makkah and the work was completed in harmony without any dispute. But when the time came to place the Kaaba, black stone of Hajar al-Aswad in its proper place, a dispute rose among the chiefs of Makkah. Everyone wanted to the honor placing the black white holy stone in its proper place. There was fear of bloodshed, but then a proposal came from a wise and old man who said that the first person to enter the Kaaba the following morning should decide the issue. He suggested was accepted by all. Next morning, the first person to enter the Kaaba was Hazrat Muhammad, who at that time was 35 years old. The people are